फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप दैट यू ऑल आर फाइन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द नेक्स्ट बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ बायोलॉजी. इन लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सेल एज वेल एज द बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडेज लेक्चर, first of all we are going to revise the some important aspect of the last lecture. So you know that the what is biology. Biology is one type of science which deals with living organisms and their different type of activities. Okay, so the father of biology is Aristotle. Biology is divided into two different type of branches. The first one is botany and second one is zoology. The father of botany is Theophrastus, while the father of zoology is Aristotle. What about botany? Botany is one type of science which deals with different type of plants and their activities, while in the case of zoology it is one type of science which deals with different type of animals and their activities. Okay, so this is all about the basic information of subject biology and their different type of branches. Okay, so in last lecture we have also talked about the cell. Okay, what is cell? You know that the cell is the structural and functional unit of the life. Okay, I am writing here the definition of the cell. Okay, what is the cell? The cell is nothing but cell is the structural and functional unit of the life. You know that the first dead cell was observed by Robert Hooke in the year of 1665, while first living cell was observed by the scientist named Anton von Leeuwenhoek, while the nucleus of cell was discovered by the scientist named Robert Brown. According to number of cells, there are main two types of organisms. If any organisms having only one cells, it means if the body of any living organism is made up of only one cell, then it is known as the unicellular organism. For example, so many different type of organisms like yeast, amoeba, paramecium, euglena, plasmodium, etc. While if the body of any living organism is made up of so many, means more than two cells, okay, sometimes tissue or organs are also there, then this particular organisms are known as multicellular organisms, and the best example is us, means human being. Okay, so this is about the last video lecture. Okay, today we will talk about the basic information of cells, means basic portion or the basic part of the cell. Okay, so we can say that for our understanding we can divide cell into main three parts. Okay, see here, for example, suppose it is a one cell. Okay, see, we are not talking about the animal cell or plant cell, we are talking about the one typical cell. So suppose it is a one cell, then this black line is known as the cell membrane. So you will remember this black line is known as the cell wall. Okay, so the first name or the first labeling is the cell wall. Now see, I am drawing the another membrane, this red membrane. Okay, so you can see the membrane having the red color, and this red membrane is known as the plasma membrane. See, I am using the word plasma membrane, or it is also known as cell membrane. Okay, so second labeling, this red colored line is known as the cell membrane. It is known as the cell membrane or plasma membrane. Cell membrane or plasma membrane, it is also known as semi-permeable membrane. It is also known as semi-permeable membrane. It is also known as selective permeable membrane. It is also known as selective permeable membrane. So two labelings are there. The first labeling is about the cell wall. Okay, it is the first labeling, cell wall. Second one is known as the cell membrane, plasma membrane, or semi permeable membrane, or the selective permeable membrane. Remember, cell wall and cell membrane both are not same. Okay, cell wall and cell membrane both are not same, both are different type of structure. So two labelings are completed. Now I am drawing here the one rounded structure, and this rounded structure is known as nucleus. Okay, so see, I am labeling, it is known as the nucleus. You know that the nucleus is known as the heart of the cell. Okay, and nucleus was discovered by the scientist named Robert Brown. So the next one is about the nucleus, and you know that the nucleus is covered by a membrane which is known as nuclear membrane. Nucleus is covered by a membrane which is known as nuclear membrane, and sometimes so many tiny apertures are there in the nuclear membrane which are known as the nuclear pores, nucleopores. Okay, so this one is nucleus, and nucleus is surrounded by a one membrane which is known as nuclear membrane. Okay, now see here, in nucleus genetic material is there. Okay, so you can say that in nuclear membrane, what is present in nuclear membrane? Genetic material is present in nucleus. Genetic material is present. As genetic material, either DNA or RNA is there. Okay, sometimes both are present, but only from both only one will act as genetic material. So you, for now, you will remember that either DNA or RNA will act as genetic material. Okay, now say this portion, it is a one type of liquid portion. This liquid portion is known as the cytoplasm. So this liquid portion is known as the cytoplasm. So third labeling will be cytoplasm, fourth one will be the nucleus, and fifth one will be the nuclear membrane. So this one is cytoplasm, and you can say that all types of cell organelles are present in the cytoplasm. Okay, so you will remember what will be the location of all types of cell organelles. The location will be cytoplasm. So see the diagram, you can see the cell wall. Second one is cell membrane. Okay, and or it is known as plasma membrane or semi-permeable membrane or selective permeable membrane. This rounded shaped structure is known as nucleus, and nucleus is surrounded by the nuclear membrane, and nucleus is known as the heart of the cell. Why nucleus is known as heart of the cell? Because nucleus having the genetic material, either DNA or RNA. You know the full form of DNA and RNA. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid, while RNA means ribonucleic acid. So it is the basic diagram of the cell. Now we will write the information about the all these parts. So first portion which is known as the cell wall, first part or the first portion which is known as the cell wall. We can say that cell wall is what? It is the outermost layer of the cell. It is the outermost layer of the cell. So we can say that cell wall is the outermost layer of the cell. What will be the function? What will be the function of the cell wall? Okay, we can say that with the help of cell wall, proper shape will be given to the cell. So it provides, we can say that it provides proper shape. It provides proper shape, and cell wall is also responsible for the mechanical support. Cell wall is also responsible for the mechanical support. So because of cell wall, proper shape will be given to this particular cell, as well as mechanical support will be given, as well as we can say that the third function will be cell wall provides protection. Okay, cell wall provides protection to the cell. Okay, protection from what? Protection from the foreign particles. Okay, protection from what? Protection from, we can say that protection from the foreign particles. Protection from the foreign particles. Okay, foreign particles means what? The all particles or the all materials which are coming from the outside of the cell. Okay, these are known as the foreign particles. So see, two points are there for cell wall. Cell wall is the outermost layer of the cell. What will be the functions of cell wall? The first function is to provide shape. Second function is to provide mechanical support, and third function is what? To give protection to the cell from the foreign particles. Remember, in foreign particles, different type of microorganisms like virus as well as bacteria are included, because these microorganisms are not a part of the cell. Okay, so you will remember what is the meaning of foreign particles. All the particles which are coming from the outer side of the cell are known as the foreign particles. So 2 points are completed for the cell wall. Point number 3, we can say that cell wall is made up of what? Cell wall is made up of cellulose. So you will remember, cell wall is made up of what? Cell wall is made up of cellulose. Okay, what is cellulose? Cellulose is nothing but it is one type of sugar. You can say that it is one type of carbohydrate, or it is one type of polysaccharide. It is one type of polysaccharide. So we can say that cell wall is made up of cellulose. Okay, different type of materials like hemicellulose are also there, and in different type of organisms, different type of materials are included in the cell wall. But the main thing is what? The main thing is cellulose. So you will remember, cell wall is made up of what? Cell wall is made up of cellulose. So these are the 3 points or the basic informations about the cell wall. Now see, I am writing the second one. Second one is what? Second one is cell membrane. Second one is cell membrane, which is known as plasma membrane, which is known as selective permeable membrane or the semi-permeable membrane. Okay, so first point, we can say that what is cell membrane? It is one type of membrane. It is one type of membrane which is made up of, remember, which is made up of what and what? Which is made up of lipid plus protein, lipid plus protein plus carbohydrate means sugar. Plus carbohydrate means sugar. So cell membrane is one type of membrane which is made up of lipid as well as protein as well as carbohydrate. Point number 2, we can say that cell membrane is present in both. Cell membrane is present in both animal cell as well as प्लांट सेल. सेल मेम्ब्रेन इज प्रेजेंट इन बोथ एनिमल सेल एंड प्लांट सेल, व्हाइल द सेल वॉल इज प्रेजेंट ओनली इन प्लांट सेल. सो यू विल रिमेंबर, सेल वॉल इज प्रेजेंट ओनली इन प्लांट सेल, व्हाइल सेल वॉल इज एब्सेंट in animal cells. Okay, so cell wall is present in plant cell while cell wall is absent in animal cell. But what about the cell membrane? Cell membrane is present in both animal cell as well as plant cell. Okay, so first two points are completed. It is one type of membrane which is made up of lipid, protein and carbohydrate. It is present in both types of cell, animal cells as well as plant cells. Point number three, we can say that what is the main function? What is the main function of cell membrane? See, it is one type of permeable membrane. So the function of cell membrane is connected with two transport. Okay, it is connected with two transport. So with the help of cell membrane, transportation of the different type of materials, different type of required materials like some amino acids as well as some glucose, okay, some vitamins, some minerals, okay. So transportation of this type of materials will be done with the help of cell membrane. So two points are completed. First one is cell wall, second one is cell membrane. Okay, we are going to revise this again. Cell wall present in plant cell, absent in animal cell. It is the outermost layer of the cell. Functions give, it provides shape, provides mechanical support, and the main function is to protect the cell from the outer foreign particles. Okay, sometimes pathogenic organisms as well as harmful organisms are also there outside of the cell. So cell wall is made up of a cellulose. What is cellulose? Cellulose is one type of sugar, or it is one type of carbohydrate. It is one type of polysaccharide. Remember, cellulose is the most abundant polysaccharide or the carbohydrate in this world. You will remember this. Cell membrane or the plasma membrane or the selective permeable membrane or the semi-permeable membrane. This is the membrane which is made up of lipid, protein as well as carbohydrate. It is present in both animal cell as well as plant cell, and its function is connected with the transportation. Okay, so two points are completed here. Now if we talk about the third one, we can say that the cytoplasm. Okay, see here, plasma means what? Plasma means liquid. Remember, in biology, plasma means liquid. You know that the some type of this, some these words are derived from the Greek language. Okay, so some words used in biology are derived from the Greek language. So in Greek language, plasma means what? Plasma means, you can say that, one type of liquid. Okay, what is cytoplasm? We can say that it is one type of dense liquid like structure. It is one type of dense liquid like structure which is situated or located, between what and what? Between cell wall or plasma membrane and nucleus. Okay, see here, it is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is what? It is one type of liquid like dense material. Okay, it is one type of liquid like dense material which is situated or located between cell wall and nucleus, or cell membrane and nucleus. Okay, so it's all about the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is very important because all types of cell organelles, are located or situated in the cytoplasm. Some cell organelles, like you can say that endoplasmic reticulum, वी आर राइटिंग द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ सेल ऑर्गेनिल, एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम, देन रिबोसोम, देन लाइसोसोम, देन गोल्जी बॉडी और द गोल्जी कॉम्प्लेक्स, ओके, देन यू कैन से दैट पाइरोक्सिसोम, सेंट्रियोल्स एज वेल एज बेसल बॉडीज, ओके, vacuoles are also there, some vesicles are also there. So these all are the examples of organelles. We will not talk about the this all organelles in this lecture, but later we will give the information about the all organelles in chapter number 8. But you will remember this, that all organelles are located or situated in the cytoplasmic area. Okay, so the third one is about the cytoplasm. Okay, what is cytoplasm? It is one type of liquid like material which is located or situated between cell wall or plasma membrane and nucleus. So third point is also completed. Now if we talk about the fourth one, and very important, so fourth one is what? Fourth one is the nucleus. Okay, see here, fourth one is what? Fourth one is the nucleus. First point, we can say that nucleus is known as the heart of the cell. Nucleus is known as the heart of the cell. Okay, like see, the heart of our body, okay, it is very important organ. So nucleus is known as the heart of the cell. See, why nucleus is known as the heart of the cell? So we can say that nucleus having genetic material. Nucleus having what? Nucleus having genetic material. You know that the as genetic material, either DNA or RNA is present, and nucleus having genetic material, and this genetic material is responsible for the inheritance. Okay, responsible for the inheritance. That's why nucleus is very important. Okay, third point, we can say that, you know that the nucleus was discovered by the scientist named Robert Brown. Okay, I'm writing here, nucleus was discovered by the scientist named Robert Brown. Point number four, generally nucleus is located at the central part. Okay, so we can say that generally nucleus is located at the central part or the central portion of the cytoplasm. Central part or the central portion of the cytoplasm. So point number four is about the location. Point number five, we can say that generally the shape of nucleus will be what? The shape of nucleus will be rounded. Generally the shape of nucleus will be rounded. And you know that the nucleus having the one membrane surrounding it, which is known as the nuclear membrane, and this membrane having the porous like structure, which is known as nucleopore. And if we talk about the numbers of nucleus, generally in a typical or ideal cell only one nucleus is present, but it is possible that some cell having two or more than two nucleus. Okay, but we will talk about it later. So for today, for part number one of today's lecture is completed. See, it is the some basic information about cell. We can divide cell into main three part. First part is cell wall and cell membrane. Second portion is cytoplasm, and third one is the nucleus. You will remember the location of all three different type of parts. See, cell wall and cell membrane, outermost layer, and the functions are connected with shape, mechanical support, as well as the protection. Cell membrane connected with the transport of the different type of materials, which is known as selective or semi-permeable membrane. Cytoplasm is one type of dense liquid-like structure, liquid-like material, which is located or situated between cell wall or plasma membrane and the nucleus. Okay. Now we can say that the next one is what? Next one is nucleus, heart of the cell having genetic material. Okay, so part number one is completed here, and now we will talk about the next important concept. See, we are not starting any chapter, but वी आर लर्निंग द सम बेसिक इंफॉर्मेशंस ओके एंड दिस बेसिक इंफॉर्मेशंस आर वेरी यूजफुल सो वी आर गोइंग टू रिमूव दिस पार्ट नंबर वन एंड यू विल प्रिपेयर टू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ बुक्स द फर्स्ट इज अबाउट द योर फेयर बुक इन फेयर बुक द वॉल बोर्ड वर्क एंड डायग्राम यू विल राइट विद द हेल्प ऑफ टू और थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पेन्स लाइक रेड पेन ब्लू पेन एज वेल एज ब्लैक पेन एंड सेकंड वन इज अबाउट द होमवर्क बुक ओके इन होमवर्क बुक यू विल राइट होमवर्क फॉर द इनिशियली वन टाइम एंड इन हार्ड टॉपिक्स इफ टॉपिक्स आर वेरी हार्ड देन यू विल राइट होमवर्क फॉर द two times okay so you will prepare two different type of books now we will talk about the second part means part number 2 of this lecture we are talking about the types of cell we are talking about the types of cells we are talking about the types of cell so for our understanding there are main three types of the cell okay how many types there are main three types of the cell you will remember there are main three types of the cell see I am writing here the first type the first one which is known as eukaryotic cell the first one which is known as eukaryotic cell the second one which is known as prokaryotic cell the second one which is known as prokaryotic cell and third one which is known as eukaryotic cell third one which is known as eukaryotic cell okay so we can say that there are main three types of cell eukaryotic cell prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell okay see here a word is used karyotic here pro word is used and karyotic here u word is used and karyotic so in three different type of words the one similar word is what it is known as karyotic okay so we will learn about the meaning of karyotic see karyotic means carrion karyotic means carrion and it is a greek word so in english language carrion means what carrion means the nuclear membrane remember carrion means the nuclear membrane carrion means what nuclear membrane see nuclear membrane is one type of membrane which will surround the nucleus see we are not talking about the cell membrane or plasma membrane we are talking about the nuclear membrane okay in greek language a means what a means no a means no a means absent in greek language a means no a means absent okay absence of what absence of nuclear membrane in greek language pro means what pro means the primitive type pro means primitive type means not well developed so pro means primitive type what primitive type nuclear membrane in greek language u means what u means well developed u means well developed what well developed nuclear membrane so these are the meaning of all three words a means no absent Karyon means nuclear membrane, pro means primitive, and eu means well developed. See, you know that a typical cell having three things. First thing is cell wall and cell membrane. Second one is cytoplasm, and third one is nucleus. But in the case of eukaryotic cell, the nucleus is absent. In the case of prokaryotic cell, the nucleus is of primitive type, while in the case of eukaryotic cell, well-developed nucleus is there. See here, if nucleus is absent, then nuclear membrane will be also absent. If nucleus is of primitive type, then nuclear membrane will be also of primitive type. If nucleus is well-developed, then nuclear membrane will be also well developed so here we can say that nucleus and nuclear membrane is absent in first case in second case we can say that nucleus and nuclear membrane will be of primitive type and in third case we can say that nucleus and nuclear membrane विल बी वेल डेवलप्ड, will be well developed. Okay, so we can say that the nucleus is absent, nucleus is primitive type, and nucleus is well developed. So it is first point about the nucleus for all three. Okay, second point, we can say that if we talk about the cell organelles, then all types of cell organelles are absent in this type of cell. Here all types of cell organelles are absent in prokaryotic cell, but sometimes ribosomes are present, and here in eukaryotic cell all cell organelles are present. So 2 points are completed, and now we'll talk about the last and third point. What about the examples? The examples of eukaryotic cell will be virus. Okay, so virus having this type of cell without nucleus and without nuclear membrane. If we talk about the examples of prokaryotic cell, we can say that in example all type of bacteria as well as blue green algae. Okay, blue green algae is nothing but it is one type of cyanobacteria. See, cyanobacteria is very important word, because the first living organism of this earth were cyanobacteria. Okay, and here example we can say that all types of plant cell as well as animal cell, either unicellular or multicellular. So these are the three types of the cell. Again, we are going to revise very shortly. Three types of the cell: akaryotic, prokaryotic, eukaryotic. A means no absent, pro means primitive, U means well developed. Nucleus absent, primitive type, well developed. Organelles absent, ribosomes present, all organelles present. Example: virus, bacteria, cyanobacteria means blue green algae, and all types of animal cells as well as plant cells, either unicellular or multicellular. So part number 2 of this lecture is completed. Thank you very much.